Thank you for joining with me. We are going to read Forgiveness and Supplements to A Course in Miracles Psychotherapy. And we didn't read Psychotherapy yet. We are currently reading the Song of Prayer and we are starting on Forgiveness. Forgiveness, this is the introduction. Forgiveness offers wings to prayer to make its rising easy and its progress swift. Without its strong support, it would be vain to try to rise above prayer's bottom step or even to attempt to climb at all. Forgiveness is prayer's alley, sister in the plan for your salvation. Both must come to hold you up and keep your feet secure, your purpose steadfast and unchangeable. Behold the greatest help that God ordained to be with you until you reach to Him. Illusion's end will come with this. Unlike the timeless nature of its sister, prayer, forgiveness has an end, for it becomes unneeded when the rising up is done. Yet now it has a purpose beyond which you cannot go, nor have you need to go. Accomplish this and you have been redeemed. Accomplish this and you have been transformed. Accomplish this and you will save the world. Part 1. Forgiveness of yourself. No gift of heaven has been more misunderstood than has forgiveness. It has in fact become a scourge, a curse where it was meant to bless. A cruel mockery of grace, a parody upon the holy peace of God. Yet those who have not yet chosen to begin the steps of prayer cannot but use it thus. Forgiveness, kindness, is obscure at first because salvation is not understood, nor truly sought for. What was meant to heal is used to hurt because forgiveness is not wanted. Guilt becomes salvation, and the remedy appears to be a terrible alternative to life. Forgiveness to destroy will therefore suit the purpose of the world far better than its true objective, and the honest means by which this goal is reached. Forgiveness to destroy will overlook no sin, no crime, no guilt that it can seek and find, and love. Dear to its heart is error, and mistakes loom large and grow and swell within its sight. It carefully picks out all evil things and overlooks the loving as a plague, a hateful thing of danger and of death. Forgiveness to destroy is death. And this it sees in all it looks upon and hates. God's mercy has become a twisted knife that would destroy the Holy Son he loves. Would you forgive yourself for doing this? Then learn that God has given you the means by which you can return to him in peace. Do not see error. Do not make it real. Select the loving and forgive the sin by choosing in its place the face of Christ. How otherwise can prayer return to God? He loves his Son. Can you remember him and hate what he created? You will hate his Father if you hate the Son he loves. For as you see the Son, you see yourself. And as you see yourself, is God to you. As prayer is always for yourself, so is forgiveness always given you. It is impossible to forgive another, for it is only your sins you see in him. You want to see them there and not in you. That is why forgiveness of another is an illusion. Yet it is the only happy dream in all the world, the only one that does not lead to death. Only in someone else can you forgive yourself, for you have called him guilty of your sins, and in him must your innocence now be found. Who but the sinful need to be forgiven? And do not ever think you can see the sin in anyone except yourself. This is the great deception of the world, and you, the great deceiver of yourself. It always seems to be another who is evil, and in his sin, you are the injured one. How could freedom be possible if this were so? You would be slave to everyone, for what he does entails your fate, your feelings, your despair or hope, your misery or joy. You have no freedom unless he gives it to you. And being evil, he can only give of what he is. You cannot see his sins and not your own, but you can free him and yourself as well. Forgiveness truly given is the way in which your only hope of freedom lies. Others will make mistakes, and so will you, as long as this illusion of a world appears to be your home. Yet God himself has given all his sons a remedy for all illusions that they think they see. Christ's vision does not use your eyes, but you can look through his and learn to see like him. Mistakes are tiny shadows quickly gone that for an instant only seem to hide the face of Christ, which still remains unchanged behind them all. His constancy remains in tranquil silence and in perfect peace. He does not know of shadows. His the eyes that look past error to the Christ in you. Ask then his help and ask him how to learn forgiveness as his vision lets it be. You are in need of what he gives, and your salvation rests on learning this of him. Prayer cannot be released to heaven while forgiveness to destroy remains with you. God's mercy would remove this withering and poisoned thinking from your holy mind. Christ has forgiven you, and in his sight, the world becomes as holy as himself. Who sees no evil in it sees like him, for what he has forgiven has not sinned, and guilt can be no more. Salvation's plan is made complete, and sanity has come. Forgiveness is the call to sanity, for who but the insane would look on sin when he could see the face of Christ instead? This is the choice you can make, the simplest one, and yet the only one that you can make. God calls on you to save his son from death by offering Christ's love to him. This is your need, and God holds out this gift to you. As he would give, so must you give as well. And thus is prayer restored to formlessness, beyond all limits into timelessness, with nothing of the past to hold it back from reuniting with the ceaseless song that all creation sings unto its God. But to achieve this end, you first must learn before you reach where learning cannot go. Forgiveness is the key, but who can use a key when he has lost the door for which the key was made, and where alone it fits? Therefore, we make distinctions so that prayer can be released from darkness into light. Forgiveness's role must be reversed and cleansed from evil usages and hateful goals. Forgiveness to destroy must be unveiled in all its treachery and then let go forever and forever. There can be no trace of it remaining if the plan that God established for returning to be achieved at last. I need to repeat that since I chopped it up. There can be no trace of it remaining if the plan that God established for returning must, I'm sorry, be achieved at last and learning be complete. This is the world of opposites, and you must choose between them every instant while this world retains reality for you. Yet you must learn alternatives for choice, or you will not be able to attain your freedom. Let it then be clear to you exactly what forgiveness means to you, and learn what it should be to set you free. The level of your prayer depends on this, for here it waits its freedom to ascend above the world of chaos into peace. And so it is. And that is part one. We read the introduction in part one of forgiveness. Thank you so much for joining with me in the Song of Prayer. I love you. Have a beautiful day.